Is this the Krusty Krab?
No! This is Patrick!
Hi, I'm Patrick Shanahan, and this is my last lecture.
Chapter 1, An Injured Lion Still Wants to Roar.
I believe my spirit animal is a dog. Dogs are very selfless and care about others before themselves. They also try to protect the ones they love most.
Drop the politics and bring us together again. Maybe if I go platinum, they'll remember me then. Maybe if I go platinum, they'll remember me then.
Chapter 4, The Parent Lottery.
But I'm not defined by the sales of my first week, cause in my mind the only way I fail if my
first. My parents are my world. Without them, I wouldn't have had the opportunities to succeed today. My parents have always been there for me through my toughest times and my highest triumphs, and I love them for that.
Racing like a runaway freight, living life to the fullest until I hit up them gates. It's like, I'ma get up today. I don't know how, but I'ma find a way. Looking for the sun in a world of gray. Feeling like my dream is a world away. I'ma get up today. I don't know how, but I'ma find a way. Searching for the sun in a world of gray. Feeling like my dream is a world away. Feel like. I used to wonder what it feel like. Yeah.
Chapter 7, Never Made It to the NFL. Baseball has taught me many life lessons. It has taught me that nothing is handed to you in life, and you have to go out and earn it yourself. It has also taught me about failure and how to deal with this failure. If you cannot overcome your failures from the past, you cannot prepare yourself for the future. Chapter 11, The Happiest Place on Earth. The happiest place on earth is none other than the baseball field for me. The baseball field allows me to clear my head and have fun with my friends. So many great moments have been on the baseball field that I will never forget for the rest of my life.
It's motherfucking paid.
Can't nothing stop me, I'm on the road. Always on time cause my eyes is on my rodeo legs. I don't trust nobody or no. Nobody put my homies on the payroll. With me now where you'll never know. If you want with me in the beginning, you get no love. My name Bobby Tarantino. Yeah, Logic ain't here right now. Leave a message if you want. Hold it, bring it back. I'ma call you back. Too busy counting stacks. Picking up the slack. I was born in a trap. Chain is all cuckoo. Logic never wanna flex, but Bobby finna bring a fact.
Chapter 21, Jay. One of my guardian angels is my sister. She's always there for me when I need help, and I'm always there for her when she needs mine. Even though we'd have our differences at times, I still love her for always being there for me. My second guardian angel is my mom. She's always looking out for me and putting my needs before hers. Chapter 24, A Recovering Jerk. Everybody makes mistakes, especially me. The lesson for life that I've learned is to learn from your mistakes to make you a better person. Only from learning from your mistakes will you be able to correct yourself in the future. Chapter 28, Dream Big. Dreams are what make you, you. How big or small you think a dream can be, you can achieve anything you put your mind to with hard work and passion for it. The only person that's going to stop you is the person in the mirror. If you say you can't do it, you're not going to be able to.
Chicago, no, I'm a snap. Not to say no basic rapping, so they wonder who am I. So
Chapter 53, Never Give Up.
Right now I'm happy.
Derek Jeter once said, "There may be people who have more talent than you, but there is no excuse for someone to work harder than you. The only true failure is the failure to try. When life knocks you down, you only have two options. Get back up and punch life right back in the face, or stay down and quit." Last summer, when I was pitching during baseball, I heard a pop in my elbow. I later learned that I had fractured my elbow and it would put me out for more than 6 months. I then learned how much I love the sport of baseball. It has put me through so many good memories, and I've met so many great people playing the sport that I needed to get back to playing it again. I'ma bring it back to the basics. Chapter 56, Make a Decision, Tigger or Eeyore. Before high school, I could believe I was Eeyore. Now that I've started and gotten used to high school, I believe I've changed to Tigger. I think this is because of people that I surround myself with. I don't have a lot of friends, but I have a lot of good friends to me. They might not be the most popular kids at school, but they always seem to make me smile whenever I need it. Whenever I'm with my friends, I always try to have a positive vibe, but I'm never scared to express how I really feel sometimes.
I've also learned that you don't get to choose your family, but you do get to choose your friends. To keep me from getting to you, baby. Remember the day I set you free. I told you you could always count on me, darling. From that day on, I made a vow. I'll be there when you want me, some way, somehow. Oh, baby, there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, baby. Oh, no, darling.
No wind, no rain. All winter's cold can't stop me, baby.
No, no, baby.
Cause you are my
love. If you're ever in trouble, I'll be there on the double. Just send this for me, oh, baby.
My love is alive. Ooh. Down in my heart, although we are miles apart.
If you ever need a helping hand, Chapter 61, The Dreams Will Come to You. Your dreams are not going to come overnight. You're going to have to put hard work and dedication into what you want to achieve. You can't achieve your dream all at once. You're going to have to take baby steps to lead up to it. Thoughts and reflections.
The first word of advice I have for you is to just be yourself. If people don't accept you for who you are, don't change yourself. You're not there. The second bit of advice I have for you is whatever you're doing in life, have fun doing it. If you're not having fun doing what you're doing, why are you doing it in the first place? And the last bit of advice I have for you is, well, this.
Painters, we'd like to be poets, we'd like to be writers, but as everybody knows, you can't earn any money that way. What do you want to do? When we finally got down to something which the individual says he really wants to do, I will say to him, you do that. And forget the money. If you say that getting the money is the most important thing, you will spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like doing in order to go on living, that is to go on doing things you don't like doing, which is stupid, but is absolutely stupid. Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. And after all, if you do really like what you're doing, it doesn't matter what it is. Somebody's interested in everything. And
everything you can be interested in, you'll find others who are. But it's absolutely stupid to spend your time doing things you don't like and to teach your children to follow in the same track. See, what we're doing is we're bringing up children and educating them to live the same sort of lives we're living, in order that they may justify themselves and find satisfaction in life by bringing up their children, to bring up their children to do the same thing, so it's all wretch and no vomit. It never gets there. Therefore, it's so important to consider this question: what do I desire?